spoof.
All right. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Is that working for you? All right, wake you up. I'm Andrew Jackson. I'm joined with Jennie Shen, Two Don Pro. We're going to comment yet another round from the, this is day one.
Day one.
Round two, U.S. Open Master Division.
Yeah.
It's been a beautiful day here in Boston. Actually, it's been kind of rainy.
It was raining the whole day.
Raining the whole day, but, you know, we didn't see that much of it because we were hard at work. I saw your commentary of the Redmond Cup earlier. It was wonderful.
Thank you.
Well done. You and Lionel did a great job. And tonight we're watching... Andy Liu, take on Zhang Chen. Zhang Chen. Thank you. I'm going to be struggling with that all night, I'm sure. Who we don't know that much about, actually. We know Andy Liu. He's our one pro from, you know, from the United States.
Mm-hmm.
Also known as Big Bad Wolf on KGS. I think he's also Strive on Taijim. I'm not sure.
I think this Chinese player, he's visiting from China.
Visiting player.
I don't know him personally.
And so I guess we'll see what we can learn about him over the course of the game, huh?
Okay.
We'll spy on him.
Andy's white.
Through his style.
Andy's white.
We're off to, I guess, a fairly standard sort of opening.
Yes.
So far. Asking for, you know, the mini Chinese, or I guess the micro Chinese.
What is the question?
But instead, does this have a name? Is this something that they're still experimenting with, or is this sort of like a few years ago? Or
this is micro Chinese. This is micro Chinese.
This is mini micro or
micro.
I don't know what it is.
There's no name. Well, you can say whatever you want. And this one, large Kima, I think that lots of people they think this one, you have seen the AlphaGo opening, right? This one, right? They have played a lot of this one. And because of this attach move, some people don't like black. Some people.
Do you peep here first?
You ask AlphaGo.
Ask AlphaGo. Okay, but because of this attach move, people don't like black.
Some people, not everyone. Some pros like it, some pros don't like it.
Mm.
So the people who don't like it, they play here.
Mm.
The people who like it, they still play here.
Because if they've played here, if they don't like it for black, now when white attaches, it's too good for black.
Right. So if it's a large came out, because the corner is more open, so white is not going to attach.
Because now I'm happy, right?
This helps
that's
black.
For you.
So if you don't like this attach, then you play large Kima.
I see. So it's a very advanced plan.
I watched the top players doing commentary.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they said, that they try to change it to large Kima. But you know, the current pros, they really like cash. So so this is more open.
It's
that
not
means
cash.
It's not cash.
Right.
And right, so
so
this
check.
Is some people will play here because of this attach.
Mm.
So I don't know if this is the black player, if that's a reason he played that, but I don't know.
Well, he makes this one first.
Yeah, he played this one first. Actually, this one was popular for some time, but now I think a lot of things have changed. So like I don't see this move now.
Mm.
It's always here because maybe the direction is not clear.
You will want to decide that maybe you want to
right,
play here.
Right, maybe. And especially after the Komi was changed to 7.5, lots of pros think the opening is more important than before.
More important than ever.
Especially for black.
For black to catch
right,
up with the
Komi. Because they feel like they're 1 point, 2 points. They think it makes a difference.
Hmm.
Well, that is a good thing because they really work very hard on openings.
All right, right. And we've seen a lot of innovation in the last couple of years.
Yes.
Especially with, you know, the AlphaGo, of course.
And AlphaGo said this jump is a slow move.
I guess so.
AlphaGo
I guess
didn't
that the
like
peep,
it.
You know, go yeah, figure.
Yeah, we don't know what we're talking about.
We'll have to ask.
We have to ask AlphaGo.
We'll have to ask. But that's not what we, you know, it's a very different.
Yeah, this is a different game.
Mm.
But I just watched the second game. AlphaGo said AlphaGo didn't like this move.
Really?
Oh, you didn't know that?
I didn't know that. How did he say he didn't like it? Did he?
Well, he didn't watch AlphaGo's lecture.
I did not manage to watch the lecture. You watched the lecture, I take it.
Tuesday, we're going to talk about it.
Tuesday.
At the mainland, Kim and me will do a lecture about AlphaGo's five games.
Oh.
We'll talk about it.
We'll be sure to see if we can get that videotape. Other lectures, I think Thursday there's a Computer Go Symposium that they're going to talk
about
Game
Thursday.
5.
Yeah, that's very cool.
Yeah, we're going to see how much of that we can get done for them. So
this is a game.
Different choice.
And then, you know, I walked into the Strong Players room, and I saw this move sitting here. I was like, my eyes are funny, and did I see it wrong?
Is that right? Because I don't know if I've seen this one.
Well, this one is very normal. Mm-hmm. And I have never seen this move from Strong Players games.
I don't know if I know any Joseki from this
move. I've never
move
seen
at
this
all.
Move from. So, but we should keep our mind open that we can ask if this is bad or good. We don't know, right?
Sure.
Because if it's something we have never seen, we should.
Maybe it's not bad or good independently. We'll have to see what happens,
right.
And then we can decide.
And the funny thing is that Ninja walked in, and I said, Mr. Zhang, have you ever seen this? So Andy played here.
That's right.
And he walked over. No.
No, he just says no and he's out of here. That's Mingju Zhang, who you might have seen this morning,
yeah.
Stephen Hu.
So
they did the round one of the Open. You can catch that on the archives page.
Yeah.
The VOD, as the kids say these days. So I've never... This is...
Well...
The big knights move.
I don't... Well, I have seen this at, like, the students' games. And I told them I didn't say this move's bad. I usually tell them, I have never seen this move ever.
And they usually hear this must be bad.
Then they just assume this is
bad. That means it's bad, but it doesn't mean it's bad. It's
well,
not necessarily
that's not what
bad.
I said,
right?
Right.
You just said you've never seen it before. That's
yeah.
Right. So.
Well, but usually I tell them that this stone is not a good place if white just pushes. Because, like, if it's a high pincer,
right?
And white pushes.
Right now.
And then
how
white comes here.
Yes.
So it seems like this stone is not as good as this one.
It seems like now it's harder for black to continue with the fight
The fight is will be very different. But, well, we have to study it. And I think Andy is like... I guess he has never seen this move ever.
Maybe he thinks there's a trap.
He thinks, okay, you do something different, then I do something different, too.
And so maybe I guess that explains the next move by black here.
Yeah, and I saw their result, and I don't know, actually. I don't know. So let's look at the game. White honey. Right, so this is actually has the Joseki move, right? If this is a high pincer.
Yeah, so if this is a high pincer, I've seen this only a couple
times.
It is a move, I think,
yes,
right?
Yes, yeah.
And so what is the Joseki if this was a high pincer? Maybe we should...
Well, there are many variations, but this is rare. This large... What do you call this?
Large knight's move? Or extra large knight's move?
Extra large.
I don't know.
Extra large.
There's knight's move, large knight's move, extra large knight's move?
Okay.
I don't know. What do you call it in Chinese?
I don't know. Extra large.
I don't know.
Okay.
How did we do here? We do here.
Here and then back. But this one is like you can have the simple version. You can have the, for example, white fix it here, right? This is a simple version, a peaceful result. But if this stone is here, it's different because white is not gonna play here. This is at a better place than this one. Right.
Right. Absolutely.
Yeah. So that's funny. So when this stone is here, maybe white. I don't know what is the best move for white locally. But in the game, Andy chose this one. Well, I think that's so. If you get into some kind of situation, you don't know what to do. Just choose a simple one.
This seems to protect the cut, you know, because there's a super complicated variation this way.
When this is here,
of course, I think this can't happen for.
That's
the
latter version.
Right. Well, that's what I'm saying. Is this difference here must mean that white has to play like this to not be dead.
This stone is here, then this move will be nice because there's a kema, right? But if this move's here, he doesn't want to play here. Because, it affects the eye shape. So
instead he plays here.
Yeah. Well, I think that I would choose something simple and easy because if it's something you don't know, just choose something simple. And then study it.
And so now, with this one instead here, what do we think?
This is not Well, this looks okay for both sides.
Okay for both.
Yeah. And they both chose a simple one.
Okay.
Well, the only difference is this stone. But I think that somehow I feel like this stone is at a better place.
It's actually better off than it would be high because it has more Aji here, or?
It's unclear, but I feel like this variation, maybe low is good, actually. Mm. So maybe small kema is one way for white. Mm. I would try small kema, but he has his...
extra large kema.
Extra large.
He got it supersized, went to McDonald's. Extra.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Living in New York a while. But white has sente, and so white turns then to pincher up here.
Yeah.
And I guess globally, if it's here, I feel like it would be easier for black to develop this side. Whereas when it's here, white says the top is important. Is that?
Yeah. So locally, it's like this area, the eye shape, everything, like the one to the cut.
Mm-hmm.
It's slightly different, but I think this corner, it's okay. It's just like, okay, this is finished.
Mm.
And it's 50-50, that's fine. Let's move to the other.
Let's go find something else.
Hi.
Yeah. So we don't want to work very hard on this corner.
Okay.
About this toothpaste low pincer move.
Let's move right along then. Moving swiftly on.
So why play this pincer?
And this is almost like a Joseki sequence that happens.
Joseki sequence.
After the hane. Double hane.
Double hane.
That's right.
Atari.
Connect. Cut.
Yeah. Oh, black took this one.
He did.
What if black comes here?
I don't know.
And then white comes here, right? And then black pushes. I think white is gonna peep first.
And then black has to run?
It's white's turn.
Oh, sorry.
White will extend.
And now I would
and
assume that black would play here.
Yeah.
But maybe not.
Maybe black doesn't like this variation. White will extend something like this.
Hmm.
Or maybe high or something. Well, this is another game. I think it's playable for both sides.
Hmm. Maybe black didn't like it, though, so, you know.
Well, he took the corner.
Right. Gave the outside to white.
I think maybe black thinks he already has a stone here, so he wants to give white this influence because he already has something that has a stone here to reduce the influence.
Here, then maybe the influence, or if it were here, then it would be a nice extension.
Yeah, so he thinks that the large came up, that stone is at a good place.
Hmm.
So, okay, it takes a corner.
Got it.
But, you know, I feel like after AlphaGo, I think lots of things has changed. Like, if you have one reason to say this is good, you might have two reasons to say this is bad. But we usually have one good reason to say this is good, then we will stop thinking.
That's it.
That's it. So this is good. But if you keep thinking, then maybe you'll find other reasons and say this might not be good.
So it's making us sort of question our assumptions?
Yeah.
Or maybe look a little deeper at things.
Yeah,
that
right. So
say
I think we should look deeper when we're playing.
So and this is all normal. The extra moves for white. I have a question. I had this question in my Q class recently. They said, why does white add these extra moves in the turn in particular?
You don't know the answer?
I know the answer. I just said it's...
Then why don't you give people the answer?
Because it gives white the choice of which set of moves he wants to block, right? The direction choice. That's the answer I gave my students. I didn't say it was... I'm just saying that white has the choice of which side to block. What's the actual...
You mean
answer?
This turn?
Mm-hmm.
This one move?
The turn for white, yeah.
Well, white just gets one Atari in center.
Right. Because if he doesn't make the turn, he doesn't get any Atari.
Right.
In
if he doesn't make the turn,
the
then
end?
This is the it's like this. Then
and now
no
this
more.
Turn, there's
right.
nothing. That's right.
So turn makes gives white one more center.
Right.
And a co-threat.
Mm-hmm. And if he decides he wanted this side. Anyway, slightly different, but thank you
mm-hmm.
very much, Jim.
So after that, white blocks.
Hmm.
Well, maybe this is not. This could be a good choice because this side. It's hard for white to develop, like make something big.
Hmm.
And in the game, black played this attack.
Again, sort of continuing the theme of making that hard for white to develop something big.
I think he wants to make white over-concentrated. Because white is already solid here, so just continue to make white more solid. And this side is very open. Also, black only has three stones here. So, like every move white plays here, white gets more over-concentrated, and black is much more efficient.
Making much more efficient move. Right. Would you rather move this now to here?
I'm not
if
sure.
Black's gonna add
I'd
something.
Rather move this move this stone here.
Oh, farther away?
Yeah.
Ah. So instead of here and low, you'd rather move it back.
I don't think this is a good place, but I think this is probably a better place.
Huh. All right. Great. Thank you.
And I think that another way for black is just pull back, but white would extend here. So
that's why you avoid it.
And then black has this cut, right? Black has this cut. And then have center, but then this corner will be much stronger.
Solid,
yeah.
Very solid.
So in the game, he played this extent.
And now there's still Agi here. Which I guess sort of explains white's next move, which is to just come slamming into the corner.
He played this attached.
He played this attached, that's right. I feel kind of nice to be able to get rid of the corner Agi here.
Yeah.
That seems reasonable to me for black.
If you look at things globally, sometimes you have to give up something to get something, right? So if we always look at things locally, oh, this move helps black, then I don't play it.
Mm.
But then that can be a problem for lots of people.
But in this case, it's okay to give black a little because globally white will get more.
Yeah, he thinks this already helped black, right? So he thinks this is okay to do this exchange. But I don't know, maybe some people still won't do it. But I think in this case it's okay.
So it's like if I helped you here, it's okay for me to help you more.
Yes.
Because it's the same area.
Yeah.
So I'm going to help you twice in the same place. So I can help myself over here.
But another reason is he thinks this stone helps white to jump into this side. Like with this stone, he feels like without this, he feels different. So so it's really hard to judge it. You can think this is a move that I take advantage in Sente. You can also think this is a move that help black.
Yeah. So did white take advantage of it in Sente or did he help black? Jury's out, I guess? We don't
it
know.
Can be, I think both are right.
Both are right.
And yeah, that's a difficult part.
That's the fun part. That's
the
fun
part.
Absolutely. That's my favorite part, at least, where I'm like, let's figure out which of these becomes the truth, right? Like,
okay.
Anyway.
But when the game is going on, things will change. Mm-hmm. Later, you don't know. You still don't know.
So if black plays this now, and then white plays the attach, is black going to respond differently? Or still maybe the same?
Maybe the same.
Mm. Okay. Thank you. Hard question. I'm asking you the hard questions. I'm sorry, Jennie.
No, it's a good question.
Because it seems to me that...
But it can be different. So
could be different
so,
later.
Right. Because this is like a pro.
Mm.
Ask black.
Which,
reply,
what's
reply. And that white would decide what he would do if after that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm wondering, yeah, this is one move, and this is another way.
Maybe closer.
But is black going to play here? That's possible.
I feel like if I'm white, I'm happy.
You're happy.
I maybe. I don't know. I feel like maybe a kick. Or something. Or the attach. Is the attach too much? If I have to kick
it. You said you like it. Then you show me a variation.
Well.
Why do you like it?
I feel like maybe this is okay. If this is small enough, I'm making more here. But I don't think black would be this submissive. Yeah, see, that's... And now I fall apart. Let's not
no,
look
no,
at...
No, no, no,
well.
No. Why do you...
Mm-hmm. Looks like a fight. It looks like fun. This game looks like fun. I don't know if I'm in a place where I want to fight now.
I think this is probably a little greedy.
Greedy? Mm-hmm. So maybe take it easier. Okay.
So this one is fine.
Hmm.
Black has three corners. So white has... So this side is open. And after this, there's a push and a cut.
Hmm. So maybe easier just to move this here so that it's closer to the cut.
After this jump, the push and cut it would be good for white. you see locally, we see this pushing cut, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because white has two many stones help, so this cut, white's cutting stone is connected to the other stones. So white is, actually this is very big, the cut. Black needs to fix it.
Hmm. I think he's going to try to fix it in Sente because he first cuts here.
This cut fix that cut?
No. He just wants to deal with this side so he can get both sides. This is my guess.
Okay.
Yeah, you like that's terrible guess, but thank you. I appreciate it.
I think you're funny. Because you said he fixed it and he put stone here.
Yeah, this totally fixes that cut all the way over there, obviously, right? Yeah, maybe not. I was told I have to tell jokes to keep you awake, so, you know, I'm going to be doing my best here.
Okay.
My moves, best jokes I know, that's for sure.
This is a game.
This is the game.
Okay.
Seems maybe small.
Well, after that, if I play white, I will push.
And cut? Could black just fade?
If you push, you must cut.
If you push, you must cut. Can black just fade?
You continue push. And then?
I don't know.
And then? Well. Then this becomes nice.
Too big.
It's nice.
Nice. Okay. Maybe. Maybe
so
it shouldn't be nice.
If black blocks, white cuts, right?
Hmm.
And this is Sente. White needs to fix this cut. After that, white can black do. He might not want to do this. But if black cuts, white just needs to retire from the second line.
Mm-hmm.
I think this cut is severe. So in the game, white played this cap.
Mm-hmm. Still preparing this cut? Or is this sort of worry about this cutting stone first?
Maybe he wants to reduce this first.
Mm.
He thinks this is Sente. If black ignores it, white will come out from here.
Aha. Uh-huh. So black exchanges here.
This exchange, white is happy, right?
To make that exchange?
Mm-hmm. Why?
I'm not sure. My guess is that it makes this less of a problem.
That's probably one thing. Another thing is this is the wrong direction for black. Black is pushing white to the outside.
It's pushing him out this
way. Yes. And this side, black cannot build anything.
It's nothing big.
Right. Nothing big. So.
So he's happy to have this.
This is the direction white wants because it's facing the open area, right?
Mm.
That's why usually black doesn't want to do this exchange. But I think he wants to fix this extend in Sente. So that's why he has to pay the price to do this.
So could white cut now?
You mean ignore that?
Well, because he answers. White answers here. And then black comes to... And the lights turn off. And black decides to protect this cut by cutting here.
This doesn't protect the cut. White is going to attack from here.
Uh-huh.
So make sure that white doesn't, if you play white, you make sure you don't attack here.
Because then the cut is protected.
Right. Yeah, then it's protected in Sente. And white is very squeezed.
And he gets a free
right.
one here.
This is extremely over-concentrated for
mm-hmm.
white. So this is the only move. Atari from the second line, and then white comes here. This is a force.
And so the cut apparently not protected, but
black
Tanuki's anyway. He's worried about this development here. That's an interesting move.
That
five spaces.
That cut is still there.
Mm.
It's still a cut. Well, because if white cuts, then there's a moyo, right? You see that if white pushes and cuts, then this becomes a moyo. And I mean, black has to run.
And then white's going to build up the side naturally.
Mm-hmm.
If this black group runs, then white would work towards territory here, or?
Well, it depends, right?
But
at least this becomes a weak group.
Hmm.
White played here. We're still aiming something on this side. So if white, if we look at, if we play the big board and ignore these baby things, then what do you want to do?
Cut.
You know what I mean by
I
big board?
I
want to
cut. Large scale? Or
yeah.
Versus like the tactics around
yes,
that?
Yes, yeah.
So I guess I would still, I would want to maybe...
Maybe block here first?
Yeah, block on that side, thank you.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Mm. And I still want to cut here. I think this is really nice.
For white?
The cut.
Makes
yeah.
this really...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, let's see. He played, oh, he's going to push it. Ooh, honey! No, I mean, I was looking at that.
Yeah, the move Jennie is looking at.
Is. So let me see. Let me tell you what I was looking at. So I was looking at, because if white pushes and cuts directly, the only thing white is not happy is this extent inside there. But actually, right now, black can will not do that because white can atari from here.
Mm.
Right. So this helps the outside. Then black will be debating.
These three stones are even weaker by giving
yes.
this exchange.
So black might not
want
to do that.
Right.
And he, so I was wondering if you want to get everything, then honey first, then push and cut, and black will not even get that.
Doesn't even get that descent.
But I suddenly saw something.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's okay.
Why is it okay?
Yeah, it's okay. I was, well, if this is down here, you see there's something here?
For what?
For black.
Yes, the cut and descent.
Wow, good.
Hey, I gotta redeem myself somehow.
Yeah,
can
right.
I keep my beard this time?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Whew. You don't have to shave.
Oh, excuse me. This one here.
Yes, so, right, after
white has
that,
to play
white
that way.
Has to the, go
and
there.
Boom,
and then,
Atari, and the whole top dies. We have a question from the audience.
Yes.
The question from the audience is C10 important?
It is.
It
very
is important.
Big.
It's definitely the big point that white is trying to aim at.
Well, but only when you are trying to.
When white wants to cut and
wants
build
this side.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah.
So Andy played the push and cut. I'm happy.
Yeah.
Because I want to do that.
And he kind of got everything here.
Yes.
Right? He got
I
want to
do that. So
push,
after this,
cut.
Because white connect, white if white, for example, if black plays here. This is not here. Then white can fix this here. And then the corner, there's something.
There's a weakness here. In the
yes.
corner, that's right.
There's
would
a
you
cut.
Cut or clamp?
Cut.
Cut?
If cut works, you cut.
If the cut doesn't work, then you clamp. Okay.
I don't know. If the cut doesn't work, then it's a different shape.
Different shape. So when we say the cut works, the sequence we're looking at here is?
White can extend.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And
white
this.
Can. Right. Atari and Atari.
Right.
Two Ataris. So I think that's why, but actually, well, it's okay because if black's not gonna extend white to do this exchange anyway, he doesn't need to. But that's fine; it doesn't make any.
You mean he can just connect without?
No, I mean he doesn't have to play the honey; just push and cut.
Oh, he could just push and cut directly.
Mm-hmm. But this is fine. So black just took this one.
Black just decided he didn't want any idea in the corner.
Then it's better not to do that exchange.
The honey exchange?
Yeah.
It's better for white not to make the honey exchange.
Wait, am I confused?
I don't know.
So, because this way it's like, this way it's like black extends, white connects.
Mm.
It's the same
and what,
as that one.
And what we actually want is we'd rather play here.
Right, I
because
would
it helps
play
more on the
here.
Outside.
Well, white gets a dumpling. Squeeze.
A little squeeze, yeah, but eh.
What do you... Yeah, so this one...
I'd rather have the outside, right?
But you will also feel bad about the dumpling.
I'd feel
but
less
But I still
bad.
Would play here.
Yeah.
I still would play here. So this way, black took this stone. It's like... Oh, man. No. It's my problem.
Because it's white scented?
It's white scented.
White scented.
Yeah. That's why I'm asking if I'm confused.
This is okay. You know, it's been a long day already. I've been keeping you busy. We also had to do our review this morning on KGS where we did Matthew Burrell's game.
That was Andy's game.
And Andy's game again. Yeah. And Andy looked like he was in pretty good form this morning.
Yes. So after that, why even get scented? What do we do now? Are you saying that this is all white?
This is the move I would play because it would look like fun.
Okay.
I'm not saying it's the best move. I'm
fun
saying it looks like the
fun
move.
For you.
That's correct. Mm. Absolutely. You too, I hear.
But I need to make sure it works and fun.
Works and fun. That's way harder than what I do. That's way more difficult.
Sometimes you play the movie, it doesn't work, and you tell me, because it's fun.
Uh-huh, I have said that. I have, you know, and sometimes I have some regrets. Gotta be honest. But I do think...
Well, this
for
this
me, I'd rather make this Black's problem.
Let's see if Andy plays this move.
Let's see if Andy plays this move. All right, I guess we'll see if Andy plays this move. We are caught up with the players, so we will have to wait to see.
Ah, that's current.
Mm-hmm, that's current. I wonder, this is actually kind of...
He didn't play the old move. He
kind
played
of thoughtful
this extend.
For...
So this is not Sente. This cannot be Sente. Mm. But this move makes this side very strong. So
it makes it harder for these stumps to make their escape.
Makes it hard for Black to escape.
Mm.
Because it's very far away. It's like this stone is here, and this all white stones. And these guys are weak because white doesn't have any weakness in this area.
How would you start as Black here?
You have to treat these stones light.
You just start by just...
So I think that...
being willing to give them up.
Why do you feel this is very weak? In general,
why do
this
I
kind
feel
of
very weak?
In general, this kind of shape is not very weak, right?
Which
in this case,
when you say this kind of shape, what kind of shape?
The black.
You mean with the turn and the cut
this,
stone?
This kind of thing sitting here, in general, you don't feel it's very weak, but in this case, it looks very weak.
Because these stones are strong and these stones are strong. They're absolutely alive, which means there's no option for Black to counterattack.
So, for example, if Black goes here, White can just something like this and kill it.
Because it's a threat here,
yeah.
And then I have to take.
And I think this looks dead.
Scary. It just killed me in three
even
moves.
If it's not, it's killable.
Shot through the heart. Yikes.
Yeah. It's
yeah.
Killable.
No, I mean I can see that. So White needs, Black needs to find something more nimble, more light, some Sabaki technique.
Well, if I play this game, maybe I would think about something, go from this.
What if just,
something like this?
Hmm, instead
go from
of something
outside,
like this, or like this?
And that's my first feeling, But White is gonna continue to build this. You're not gonna push and let White build this territory. So maybe it's better to play a stone like
higher,
right? Like something like this, to reduce from the. But it doesn't feel good actually.
I was about to ask, how would you decide between this one and this one? But now you're like neither of them. I don't know.
Well, if you play here, White still can play here.
Hmm.
And if Black pushes, White can honey. And it's still building
you're
a
still
big
building this whole thing.
And if you play here, White can play the shoulder hit.
Oh, the alpha go high shoulder hit, right? Shoulder hit on the fourth line. Who cares? It's all fine, right?
Okay, maybe Black would just drag that group in.
Is there any way to make Sabaki on this side? Could we start this way, maybe?
You start this way?
Give it away and then jump far.
Why do you think I'm going to run?
Why do you think White's gonna run? White's not gonna run. So then, but if you just jump, it seems like it's too hard.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, just gonna try and kill
you're it. Too close to the thickness.
Too close to thickness.
To the strength.
Right.
This is that thickness.
There's no concern about the eye shape on this group because of this honey?
Well, White has eye shape and this is a strong shape.
Mm.
So White is pretty strong here. That's why even if you want to do something, you go far away.
You go far away. Okay. And this something out here just feels like it's
well, this,
so far
this
away.
Also don't feel good.
Yeah.
So
hard.
That's why I like this push and cut.
Hard to argue with the push and cut. And now that we have push and cut, Black seems to be in trouble. Maybe not trouble, but it seems like a hard spot. Do we need to count, or... Black also has all the cash, as we were observing.
Yeah, so Black has, like, this area, 7 points and plus something here. So this is like a Komi.
Mm-hmm.
This corner, how many points?
No, 13, I would say. Maybe with a little more... 15.
And this one, there's some potential on the outside.
At least there's a couple here.
So, let's say 15. Then black has 30, right? And this is
that covers it. So that's 30. But then this is.
This is at least, well, if we ignore this one, this is 10.
Mm.
And then the white has about 20. So that feels that if white has 20, I think white is, I would take white.
Hmm. Even though white only has 20 points. And we didn't count Komi, so it's 30 to 20 with Komi already included.
Yeah, I know, but I would take white.
Because of the thickness here,
think
white is going to make 10 points.
Because of the potential here.
Mm-hmm. I did hear the proverb that a weak group costs you 30 points. So that would mean white is going to win by 20 points.
Who told you that?
Not
me.
Book of Proverbs. No, you don't want any associate. Maybe a weak group is only 10 points.
Well, it depends on what kind of weak group. So like this one, you can see that we only counted 10 earlier.
Mm.
Now this is 20, right?
Just like that. He
just
made
like
his 10
that.
Point.
Right.
Boom. So if something like this, would we expect that white will capture or extend out either way?
Stand out.
And now this is kind of like what I was talking about, where we jump really far away.
You jump really far away?
I'm treating the whole thing lightly. I'll give you those 5. I'll give them up. I can't give them up, it's too much.
You can give up everything.
I can give up, well, the theory was that if I'd gotten this and jumped out this way, would white answer that
yeah.
way?
You can't give up everything.
I can't give up everything.
So you give up everything and you don't get anything back?
I'm asking this question because I was curious if it's too much to give up, and now I know my answer. When you break out laughing and you're like, you can't give that up, then I guess it's too much to give up.
What did you get back? My question is, what did you get back?
It's limiting the total white territory, putting a cap on how many points white has.
This is most likely this is going to happen, right? He doesn't have to play this Atari, but this is his center. And then, like your move, if you give up, then white still has this line territory. That's too much.
Too much.
So if black tries to connect back, you see black cuts, and then white comes out, and black carries. Can black get out?
Oh, still might be stuck.
Don't be lazy. Read.
Tough but fair. Tough but fair. I don't see black getting out.
Dead?
It's dead, it looks like. That's what I read, that's what I saw. I mean, actually it doesn't work, so, you know.
That's what I saw, the first variation I saw. So if black cannot even jump to this line, what can he do?
Even this doesn't look very good though.
This Tenga move is beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, later, oh, he played here. It's on this line.
Mm.
Without that exchange, yes. I think Andy probably would still go from, but this direction, because
now
black
white
it,
maybe isn't making anything on white.
Well, this direction is like you're trying to kill it, because this is not the direction you want
to make territory
because
right.
Black has a solid position on this side, so there's not much white can build. So if you play here, it feels like, okay, I'm gonna kill you.
And that's the whole thing it means.
But
it
you know what's
have a
funny?
Secondary thing.
I actually have the exact same feeling as Andy. I was going to say. I was thinking about the shoulder hit.
The shoulder hit.
And
he played, and then you see it on the screen.
I saw them.
She's psychic. You and Andy both seem to like to kill things. It seems
no, it's not killing. This is like a leading attack.
Ah, leading
attack. It's like if black pushes from this side, I don't know if white just extend should be fine. And black cannot continue push, otherwise you're killing this.
Otherwise it is going to
right.
be very dangerous.
And if white, black goes out from here, white gets this turn.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like you're cutting the two groups from
each other. That's right.
Right. So that is, I like this move because that's what I would play. Because
it's a sort of a splitting attack here.
Mm.
So does black have any options to like not cooperate? Can he, you know, dodge away?
You mean to answer or should I hedge?
What are the, because the answers that you almost always want to play are here or here.
Yeah, that's
but in this case, if both of those you don't want to do,
well, that's,
what are some of these like very rare moves that you might do?
Well, that's because if you don't answer, it's going to be either this one or this one.
For
just
white.
Like said, this is very powerful for white.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why black usually would continue to push either way, right? This
right.
way. And I was, I said, just 6-10 is okay. And
nope.
And you can even think about honey. And I haven't said that yet. And white play.
Bam, honey. There it is.
So this is more severe.
Mm.
And when you honey, what do you worry about is this card, right?
Well, Andy is clearly not worried about this card.
And I think he's gonna come out from here. And now this stone is at a nice place.
Black's burden.
Yeah.
Trying to handle
well,
without having any further damage to the middle.
Yeah,
group.
I think that. So you look at this game, white only has this one territory, and there's a small corner here, even if black doesn't have so much either. But if white plays very normal, like you just let everything settle very easily.
And make territory naturally.
Yeah, I think it's not. It could be like. It could be make things, you're making things easier for black, but if you attack like this, I think first thing is this way is fun. It's fun for the players, it's fun for the audience.
All right. And
second, it's fun. Second, this can be more severe that like just, because if you just settle, it could be, it goes to a very close game, and then you fight for end game to decide who wins the game.
Boring.
Well, that's more work.
No. Well,
that's a lot
it.
Of work. That could be more work, but this is more risky.
What was it you just told me? Don't be lazy and read?
Yeah.
What's wrong with that? You have to do that, but don't be lazy and count. You know, we could maybe not have to do that if we attack really hard, right?
Okay.
Right.
And he's kind of, I saw that big screen that black is kind of forcing white to kill him.
So this is one of black's choices, is the forcing white to kill him. We mean the black is going to ignore saving this group, take territory here, and basically say, okay, white, come at me. You know, give me your best shot, and if you can't make it land, I have all the cash.
Yes,
right.
So if white cannot kill this group, black has enough cash to win. That's his strategy.
Big Bad Wolf, you know, he's kind of famous for being able to do this. That's, he huffs and puffs and blows the house down. This is the Andy Lee way.
Why is he good? Because he's good at reading.
He's good at reading, that's right.
And he has, like, good skills.
At reading?
Reading is one thing, and good skills is another thing, right? You have to see the things, see the moves, the skills. Wow!
Pushes again. It would seem like I would really not want to do that if I don't have to, right?
That's why I said he's forcing white to kill him.
But it is also sente.
Sometimes
like,
this is too greedy. Because if white ends the move here, I would say black is dead.
And this is a territory I could, you know.
White has 20 points here. White has 20 points.
Right.
And these two, let's say 10, right? Something like that.
So this territory is like finger sized, right?
This is finger sized. This
right,
is finger sized.
This is kind of palm of the hand sized, right? This is like my face sized, right?
You
like
mean this dies?
Well, you say if white gets another move, right? This would be.
If this dies, then we don't need to.
We don't even need to count, right?
We don't even need to think about it's a face or a
palm. Or the palm of your hand. That's the rule of thumb, right? Anyway, it's a different thing. Okay, moving along.
So can black still answer here? No, probably not. I really think that if white gets anything here,
it's
black
too much.
Is gonna.
But it is black's turn. Does black? Why would black need another move here? He just crawled again.
Well, if he doesn't answer, white is gonna play here.
Oh, and the question
is, actually, you know, we just counted earlier. Black doesn't have so much. But what if white has 30 and then white gains something here, white actually has enough cash.
So maybe he doesn't have to kill.
So he doesn't have to, but this is
Wait, what? Sorry, we just saw the move on the side monitor here. We see this one, and then we see this one. Why does that make you laugh?
You put the stone here like this.
Uh-huh.
And you make it like a clumsy move. And
I did. I'm sorry.
And if you make it like a good move, you do this.
Whack. It's all in how you put it down. I appreciate these lessons on the finer points. I saw Stephen getting a little bit of a talking to from Mingju early on about how to put the stones down.
I thought they're talking about push-ups.
Did Mingju make you do push-ups?
Mingju students would do push-ups
if
they make mistakes.
If they mess up their life and death problems? I tried that on my
students. Yeah, actually, Albert Yin messed up, he misread something.
Oh, yeah?
This afternoon's game. So we were talking about Lilo and me were talking about how many push-ups he needs to do.
Mingju's
going to
make him do? It's tough. So
one thing, so well, of course this is Andy's way, this is Andy's move. Another thing White can do is attack this first.
What will happen over here next? Black needs to live, I'm sure. Where do you start as Black?
Well, if Black honey here, I think White can either double honey or just extend, because this is still a big problem.
Still Black's
right,
problem.
Right, and maybe double honey. And if Black continues to build this thing for White, then this still can die.
Mm.
And if Black lives small, then White already can get something, right? Then later White defends the corner, then there's
10
another
points.
15 points.
10, 15,
right.
Yeah.
So actually this game, White is not behind by cash. So that's probably the reason he thinks this is enough. He thinks he just kills
these
guys and it's enough. But this is
a
funny
move. But maybe not though, right?
This is a funny move. I really think it's a funny move.
Okay, why is this funny? Because this is easier and more direct?
Well, it's just like, it just doesn't feel like, he just wants to kill those guys. that's my feeling. Like he just wants to kill these baby stones. That's it.
Are these too small?
No, it's like that's it. you get the feeling of the mood.
I do. It's like that's it. That's all I need. So it's kind of funny.
Okay, so here's a variation. Okay, what if Black honey?
Cross cut.
Yeah, only move.
Only move.
Only move. So is
if you ask me what comes after the crosscut, now I'm in trouble. But crosscut I got.
Don't be lazy.
Okay, sorry. Work harder, Jenny.
Is there any way
Black
can kill one stone? See, this is the difficult. But Andy must read this. I think otherwise, if he doesn't read this crosscut, then he cannot play this attach, because if Black honey, White must cut.
Mm.
So this is...
My thought is that maybe if I have this, is there some sort of driving to Suji here?
You have to make it work.
I'm not seeing how to make it work. I am having trouble making it work.
Then you can't play there.
Then you can't play there.
So this feels like there's no way for Black to kill White Stone.
Maybe we can show some examples
show
for folks.
Something.
So I was thinking maybe here, because this is Sente 4.
Okay.
Maybe I have something that I can do here, but I don't think it works. I don't think this moves out. I legitimately do not think
this
works.
This is a good looking move.
Thank you, but I don't think it works still. From my reading, I'm trying not to be lazy and read.
I still don't think
it works.
You're improving?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't read, you can't improve. That's why I ask you to read.
You're trying to help me improve? You haven't given up on me
yet, Jenny? You
don't
want to improve?
Of course I want to improve. I'm just surprised that you think I can improve. See? I knew you believed in me after all.
Of course you can.
You're so nice, Jenny. You're so nice. Just this way is simple enough?
What are you going to do?
I have no idea. I don't
think
it works.
I need to tell you one thing. Now this Atari is not Sentai.
With this one?
This one.
Oh, because it's two.
Because you take two stones.
Get
one eye,
and I'll die with the rest of it, for sure. So I'm not going to play that Atari.
And then White can continue to push. Still feels like crushed.
Yeah, I'm not seeing it. I don't think it works.
It's funny.
I thought it was good looking. It was good feeling, but I didn't see it work.
It's funny because sometimes, like, you save these Sente moves, it can be good, and you can use it for, like, you have different choices in
it's
the future.
Sente, it's Sente, it's
but
Sente.
Sometimes if you don't do it, it becomes Goten in the
it's
future.
Not Sente anymore, and then you're in trouble.
And when they were commenting AlphaGo games, they were like, well, later it can be Goten. And so AlphaGo just doesn't save anything. It just plays.
It just always plays Sente. That's right. It never waits. It's just like I gotta do it.
But sometimes it's good to wait.
Mm-hmm. So I guess Black decides he can't do it, so
yeah,
he has to.
This is
back.
The second variation we're gonna read. Right?
Mm.
And if Black honey, White has to cut.
Has to.
So.
This looks a little better, maybe.
It's not better if it dies.
It's not better if it dies. Okay.
White just plays empty turn red.
Hmm.
What can Black do?
I guess this is not centered. Huh?
Well,
from
it's okay. You're centered. That's fine.
That one will be centered.
And then?
Even with centered, there's nothing. I got nothing.
There's nothing you can
nothing.
Do. You can play.
Yeah,
it,
I was thinking maybe I. But as I would want to give him up, because I feel like there's too heavy baggage. I'd want to give him up. But like you say, you can't give him up. It's too much.
You can't give them up for nothing.
Can't give him up for nothing. Okay.
You have to get something. You have to make it a trade.
Right. Right. So there's this proverb I heard, which is that sacrifices, if somebody wants something for a sacrifice, it's not a sacrifice, it's an investment, right? So you never sacrifice anything, you're just making an investment. They weren't talking about Go, this was a different proverb.
Oh,
this
okay.
is not a Go proverb. They were saying
okay.
that when somebody says, I sacrificed something
mm-hmm.
because they want you to give them something, it means they didn't make a sacrifice, they made an investment.
Okay.
So similarly, Black is sacrificing these things if he gives them away for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's an investment if Black actually gets something from
it. Well, in this case, because he paid the price earlier he had this weakness.
Mm.
So this weakness cannot be nothing.
Right.
So he has to give White something.
Right.
Right. This is earlier. Because when we were counting, we only counted 20 points here, but we didn't count the potential. So this is the potential for White.
So we gave White only, actually we only counted 10 for White.
Earlier. After White
right.
killed the two stones, it becomes 20.
Right.
And Black just played your variation.
Oh gosh, that can't be good.
And now he just gave up the stones. He just gave up those stones.
He can't see anything better. But he didn't get anything, like you say. Oh, he did get the target. If you can say that that's something he got.
This territory has 40 points now.
White's territory is 40 points. Black's territory hasn't really changed at 30. He gets a couple more here.
He gets, yeah.
But not more than Coleman.
You think this is good for White? This is still a cut.
There's still a cut. And I think he's trying to protect the cut with this peep.
Mm. And White is not. White doesn't have to connect. White can. Like this is possible.
Mm. Would it be reasonable for White to play the knight's move? I mean, if the cut's not important, I'd rather take the corner points.
That's possible. Because if Black cuts, White is gonna extend here. Okay. This is still go. Black still has to make
has
life.
To live. Yeah.
So you think White is ahead?
It seems very likely that
I think so. I think White is ahead.
This seems like a very straightforward way to make some
points
here.
Because White is already ahead by territory, and White doesn't have any weakness, and we still see this problem for Black.
Hmm.
And Andy is...
Bam!
Still...
Tell us how you really feel, Jennie.
This is how I feel.
Whack! He's aiming at the cut. He's not... giving anything here to Black. Black's like, I'm gonna cut, and Andy's like, I don't care. It's not.
Well, this is a way.
Indirectly.
No, I think that what he's saying is, you want me to connect? No, I'm not gonna connect. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna fix this cut from here. So this is the efficient way.
How does this fix the cut?
If Black cuts, you just do the variation. If Black cuts, I think White can. If you play here, if White plays here, Black can honey.
So
that's one way. I think White can come here now. Because there's many problems. There's cut, there's this move. So and there's this side, right? So Black cannot answer here. But if Black answers anything on this side, White gets this came up. It's basically the same as earlier this.
He just gets
the variation
one.
We showed. Yeah, so this is like an attacking move to defend the weakness.
And after this exchange, after black makes this exchange, now he can actually extend this way and just take it.
Later, this stone would just die.
Just gone. It already looks like it's pretty dead.
And there's still cut.
There's still the cut.
Yeah, I think white is ahead.
Sounds likely. All right, do you want to take a break right now? Let the players get a few moves farther ahead.
Okay.
You take a little break.
Okay, take a break.
All right, we'll take a 5-minute break here. We'll come back soon. Andrew Jackson, this is Jennie Shen, 2-Down Pro. Joining us here, we're commenting the Open Masters here at the 2016 U.S. Go Congress. Don't go away. We're gonna bring it on back here, and we're gonna rejoin the game. So, had a nice break. Got to see a bunch of these. This knight's move, not yet there. So, we were talking over the break. You said you thought that Andy Liu was maybe in a comfortable position here. This was gonna be.
Yes, I think so.
White has a lead here, and it might be difficult. How could Black reverse the game? Is there what does he need to do? He needs to settle here. And
you're asking me?
I'm asking you. If he's going
to
bring it
he
back, how can you do it?
Settle where?
Settle this group in the middle. Invade Sansan. Right? Make another 5 points of territory, maybe 10 points of territory here. And also keep this group alive all at once, right?
I don't have that imagination.
Not that sort of, you know, what can I say? I'm a creative guy. This is... All right, so we did see that this cut was still here when we left, which I guess was...
Black's
next
turn,
move there was to
Black play this turn to
turn and
it.
Protect the cut.
And then Andy plays his piece.
He's just going to keep needling him at that piece, right? So
Black, if Black connects, maybe he will play this Ahani. Maybe.
Mm.
In the game, Black played this one. So if White cuts, Black is going to give up the 2 stones and get 2 more center moves.
Right, and
so
this makes my shape, I guess.
And then there's a cut, and then there's weakness, there's a honey. So that's it's not worth to take the 2 stones to gain these weakness for White.
Mm-hmm.
So White is not gonna do this. Like, there's a cut, right? After this cut, there's some problem.
Previously, this was fine. There was no problem here for White, but once these stones are on the board, then there's a problem
yes.
for White, right?
So also, White doesn't care about these 2 stones. It's just some points.
White doesn't need
to
move.
No need to trade some weakness back.
They're not cutting stones, so they're not important for White.
Yeah, so White played here. So he thinks if Black comes here, then he will play here. And then connect back. Because this way, when Black atari's here, White can atari. And then get everything here. That's
he gets
better.
Everything, no weaknesses,
yes.
no problems.
So Black played this. Got connected back. Oh, Black played the cut.
Black played the cut. Black cross cut. Because he wants to connect. He's sort of inducing, I guess, this here.
Yeah, and then White takes it. So you can see that if White, Black atari's here, White takes, then
now the cut is an
there's
issue.
There's a cut, and then But this stone is not, still not important.
It's not an eye either.
Well, white doesn't have to kill anything now. White just needs to make sure that black doesn't make anything big.
Mm.
That's it.
And then white will just sort of continue to keep
because,
that lead.
Because white is already ahead, yeah.
So similarly, after black protects, or after white protects, black decides to fly back here.
Fly back here.
Fly.
Fly.
Let's move. Kema, right? Fly.
Okay. Well, I understand this.
Is it not a fly?
I understand
it's not
this in Chinese.
Yeah, yeah.
Because in Chinese we say fly.
That's right. That's what I was going to say. It's a fly.
Okay, black pushes a cut.
Push, cut. He's looking to make some complications, right?
Well,
this is.
So Andy has his thinking. He thinks. So of course black has to push and cut. Otherwise, if black pushes from here, then if black cannot build like what you just imagined, black has to do this to win.
Yeah.
And this way, black is not doing anything.
There's none of those things that we suggested.
Yes.
Right.
So for example, if black just kills that stone, right? And white gets this, black gets this. Then it's like if white gets something, black gets something, that means black gets nothing.
Right.
And white is still ahead.
Right.
So black must push and cut. And locally, if white wants to fight with black, I think that's a bad idea.
If white wants to fight. Oh,
yeah.
I see.
Something like this, right?
Mm.
It could be a bad idea.
He doesn't. This might be the if you're aggressive, you're like, okay, I have to fight.
Because.
But if you count, you say, I'm ahead, I don't need to fight. And maybe you don't play this extension. So.
No, there's no reason to fight here for white because first of all, you see this kills the three stones.
So this.
No,
that one. So it does.
Mm-hmm.
All dead.
Yeah, I should let you do it.
Mm-hmm.
I should ask, can you kill the three?
Can
stones?
Can I kill the three stones? I would.
Well,
this is the vital point, right? Of three stones, right in the middle.
Okay,
so
if this kills the three stones and this jump will kill the two stones, then there's no reason to fight, right? Give black Mi'ai, kill white.
You would almost say, you know, how could you fight here when you're dead?
This is what you said in the morning.
That's what you said.
I'm quoting the illustrious Jennie. No, I've never said that. Someone else said that.
Well, don't let me put words in your mouth. I wouldn't want to do that.
Okay, so Andy actually played here. It's a flexible move.
Mm-hmm.
And so. Black comes here.
Mm-hmm.
I have this picture in my head. I have this picture that if black goes here and then white jumps and black has to live, and then maybe white would do something like this.
Mm.
Just make sure that black doesn't something like this. White gets something, black gets something. That's good enough.
Right.
Like if black honey, white can double honey because it's a target.
Right.
I have this picture in my head. It was not really just subconsciously you were sort of reading, but
okay. So this was your instinctual set of moves
yes,
that you look at
yeah,
first.
Yeah.
Policy network
that's,
almost you would say.
Okay, that's my policy network.
There we go.
Okay, so this is my feeling is this move.
So here's a question. Question from the audience. Why doesn't this is actually a good question for the the cue players out there. They were asking why white doesn't play here and then here. Isn't it better to have g6 here instead of e6?
Because instead of putting this stone here,
mm-hmm.
white wants to put this stone here.
Right.
Because this stone secures the corner. White would get territory in the corner. It also attacks this group and black has to look here. And after that, white will still have center move on this side. And later, at white ends move here, this will be
the corner. So that's a lot of reasons to play here.
Yeah, but
there's only one reason to play here.
There's no reason to play here.
There's no reason to play there.
Because white, I'm not trying to be mean.
No, that's fine.
I mean, this move is not like compared with this one, right?
Mm-hmm.
This one is very clear. White is profiting here, but this move has no. Like a little bit of profit,
and
there's no profit here.
I would almost explain it that since black is going to play here anyway,
yes.
you really don't need to play there.
Yes.
Right? Like if we're considering black could play either of these two extensions,
yes.
you don't want to add a move here the same way you don't want to add a move here.
Yes.
You don't want to force black
yeah.
to play that.
Sometimes you do it. Sometimes, like, you continue you want to continue to push, or you want to continue to fight here,
and
you
need
do
the forcing move.
Yeah,
but
in this case, White is not trying to fight here. White wants to take advantage on this side,
right.
So that's why he played here.
Right. Hopefully that answers your question out there, why this isn't necessarily the point that White actually wants. White wants this point.
Yeah, so when White plays here, anything Black does on this side, then white will play here to kill this cutting stone.
And
that's
now this whole group is needs to spend some more moves too.
Well, at least he will wrap this in, and then this side will be something.
Something here. Mm. So as you said, after White gets this jump down here, Black does have to go live.
Yeah. And then Black goes here. So white can, for example, like this area, what is some feeling? Like something here or something here?
Dangerous.
Something at this area, my feeling is.
So one of those rather than the diagonal move to close the corner?
Well, Black is also building something, so white wants to reduce
first
and go back here.
And then come back. Okay.
And white played this one first.
That looks...
He thinks this is center, otherwise white blocks. Black is going to die. It must be like that. Otherwise, there's no reason to play a Gote move here. So Black plays this push.
Hmm. So it is Sente. And then you get the answer to your question.
He played me.
He played your move, that's right. He played you, that's right.
Sorry.
You gotta play yourself. Somebody, you know, it's just...
I guess the two of his moves, this shoulder head and this move.
Hmm.
So same thing that White doesn't want to come here to play, because... Black jumps here, then
take Black's point.
What if White dies? Most likely White dies.
Can't do it. So just take Black's point.
Yes. So White just needs to reduce this area and make some territory here. That's an easy win for White, I think.
Does this move also close the corner, Aji?
Yes, but still there's Aji, right?
So there's still Aji.
I think
he
will go back here later.
Okay. Submarine.
This is a submarine.
Yeah, this is a submarine.
We say that in Chinese too.
Is it really the Chinese? Have a Chinese?
Yeah, we say that.
Probably what I heard.
We say submarine.
Submarine. Huh.
So if Black plays here, White can continue. So it's like White gets more than Black. The Black didn't get anything, like a few baby points.
Got this stone.
Yeah, but White gets
this.
This
yeah, but this
is
way better. That's right.
What's this?
A hand, at least a hand there.
Okay, a hand.
At least a whole hand, right? But is it funny because it's a good hand, right?
Yeah, that's pretty big.
Strong hand.
H4.
Missing the white stone at M4. Oh, we took clean.
Sorry.
The original extra large knight's move from way back in there.
Yeah. So what?
What about h4 instead of g2? So they're saying, why not here? Not this one, this one.
I'm just giving people an idea about if Black answers here, what's going on. This can be another way, but White will honey, right?
It's similar, and it's making whites bigger.
So, yeah, I think if White connects, maybe White doesn't need to go back in the corner.
Actually now has not. Maybe a co.
Maybe a co?
I don't know. I would do something crazy here and try and kill it.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know how crazy I need to be. I haven't decided yet.
You don't need to be crazy, you just need to
just
play.
Descend. Dead. D-E-D dead.
Okay. He played safe, see?
So this is a safe move for Black.
Just fix it. And Black play this attach. I don't know what's the meaning of this attach. And then White played here. You understand this move?
The squeeze? It's either I'm gonna take these two or I'm gonna get the Akari on this side.
I think he's gonna turn here.
It looks like he did.
It did?
Black captures and White connects.
Oh.
This looks fine for White. White's breaking in here.
So this is like Andy's showtime.
Andy's showtime?
Andy's show. So there's no other way for Black.
Could he have played it? after he's made this exchange, maybe he can come back.
Okay.
To dinner. Yeah, I don't think this works very well either. I mean, the fundamental problem, as we said, is even if white gets something here and black gets something here,
yeah.
black is just staying in the same place, which
yeah.
is behind.
Because
he's not catching up.
We saw black didn't gain a big thing,
right.
but white already has 40 points here.
Right.
If black crosses back here, white can't even connect this stone back.
Like this one.
Yes.
Yeah.
Then black will lose everything here. So this move. And
even though it doesn't work, he has to do it.
Well, what if black comes here? White can play here, and then white can connect here. Black has to cut, and then white comes here.
Makes liberties, that's right. So looks like it makes liberties to me. Might be being lazy, but I don't see any way. Like, this doesn't
now
seem like
you
it
know
works.
You,
this seems
now,
very handy.
Now you know you don't want to be lazy.
Well, you assume
well,
I'm being
actually,
lazy. I'm actually trying to read it, but I'm not
being
sure.
Being lazy.
Oh, there's some problems back here.
You're being lazy.
Is this cut going to be sente enough?
No.
Is those two
no.
as big as these three? Well, not after you've made it
not
these four.
These
that's
guys.
True. That's too much.
So why didn't he play this? Why didn't he play this?
I couldn't tell you. We'd have to ask him.
White connects here. The ladder works for black for white.
Yes.
The ladder works for white.
Ladder works for white. But
oops.
Can't black still turn?
No.
No. I know. I see it. You know, there's other people out there. It's not just you and me here. It's the whole internet out there. We gotta try and.
That's your excuse.
Thank you. I'm sure that. I have to be ask the silly questions. It's my job.
Oh, black Atari here.
Atari. Capture, connect.
And then connect. So if black cutting here, white kills this. I think white kills a big chunk.
And black goes to play endgame.
Endgame. Let's count now.
Okay.
It's time to count.
Can we play the next couple moves before we count? I'd love to just sort of make this solid.
Okay. Now it's easier to
count. Now it's easier to count. If you're just joining us, I'm Andrew Jackson. This is Jennie Shen, 2Pro. This is the U.S. Open Masters, live from the U.S. Go Congress. It's 2016. We're here in Boston. It was a rainy day. This is day one of the Congress. We'll be here all week. Starting tomorrow morning, it'll be Hajin Lee will be giving the pro commentary. In the evening, we'll have Kathy Lee. We'll also have the Redmond Cup tomorrow afternoon. The next round between Albert Yen and Jeremy Chu. Those streams will start tomorrow morning, starting at 9 p.m. The Redmond Cup is not tomorrow. The Redmond Cup is 8-2, so that's August 2nd. In any event, the first stream starts tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. We'll have commentary starting at 10. And then tomorrow night, we'll have the commentary. We'll start again at around 8 o'clock, I believe. 7:30, 8 o'clock. Tomorrow we'll be recording the Blind Go. It won't be live, but we will be recording it, and we'll post that recording as soon as we find it. If you're looking for the AlphaGo keynote was recorded by Boston University. Boston University is going to get us that recording as soon as they've processed it. We're working on their AV team, which is, you know, it's Sunday. They'll come back on Monday. It's the usual thing happens around here. You've finished your count?
I think black doesn't have enough.
Black doesn't have enough. Do you want to put a number on that? Just to, you know.
You were distracting me. I don't have an accurate number.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
That's my excuse.
Apologize. You know what happens? Myanmar just mutes me when we're doing the broadcast. Myanmar just turns the
volume. So you actually distract him?
No, I don't distract him at all. Are you kidding me?
If he mutes you, that means
he
distracts you.
He could probably count the game if, you know, I don't know.
I have
an earthquake happens
in California. I have a rough number
California.
When you are distracting me. I don't have an accurate number.
I apologize for distracting you. I'm sorry. I apologize for distracting her.
I think white is ahead.
Okay.
From the sequence, it makes sense, right?
Yeah, it seems like this turned into a big territory
yes.
for white.
Because this is 15.
20?
Yeah, and more than 20, of course.
Blacked out another 10 or so here.
This is 25.
And 40 still.
Oh, this is... See?
Sorry. Guilty as charged.
27. This one you just kind of like back extend in the honey.
Mm-hmm.
75. White has 75. There's something here. So white, I think black. White just needs to play simple. And white is ahead.
Great. It looks like white is.
I was going to say if white can take this in center, it's more clear. Because
exchange is here first.
Because
but then yeah, it takes it. Yeah.
Because this Atari.
Now there's less problems for. Saves the two. That turn.
And then
plays there.
Okay, this is a good show.
Andy
did a good job.
You want to stop commenting?
We can
keep going.
We can keep going.
Sure call.
I think this game is gonna finish not.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
So tomorrow, are you doing commentary tomorrow?
No.
You're free?
I'm still doing commentary. I'm doing too much.
You're doing KJS commentary?
No.
Okay.
I will review tomorrow.
Game reviews tomorrow. So if you're not at the Congress, you haven't made it to the Congress, one of the things that happens is we have a number of visiting professionals who provide all sorts of lessons for Congress attendees during the week. They provide game reviews. My personal favorite, game reviews from Jennie Shen. I've learned so many Josekis from Jenny.
You ever come to my game review?
Oh, you don't remember? If she doesn't remember reviewing my games, I'm probably happier that way. We're probably both happier the less we remember the
game
reviews.
I remember.
The infamous source of Brady's blunders, I think, is the game reviews there. Anyway, we have game reviews. Pros will also be giving simuls, and some pros will give lectures and workshops in the mid-game. Plus, we have other tournaments. The 9x9 tournament happened tonight. There's a running evening league that happens. Let's see. Tomorrow, or not tomorrow, but Tuesday, will be Team Relay Go, which should be pretty entertaining. Unfortunately, the professional Team Relay Go fell through, so it's going to be a much more casual event at Congress where all players will be able to try to hand a Team Relay Go. What do you want to talk about?
I'm counting.
I keep distracting
with your
you?
With the distraction.
Maybe I'm just trying.
I can count. White has 80 points.
Is it good practice? am I able to help you practice counting with distractions?
White is gonna win. I think white is ahead.
Well, we can certainly take another break if you'd like to let the players get farther out in front. I think we're all caught up here with.
If you want to count, that'd be good.
Do you want to tell them what's coming up tomorrow? Tell them about your plans for the day off?
You just know them.
I mean, you think I'm not working here. I'm working hard. This is. All right.
You just
find
all
count,
kinds of excuses to. You don't want to count.
Well, I don't know. It sounds like you don't want to, you know, do the announcements. Could be either way.
If you count, I can count more accurately.
That's the truth of it, huh?
I think White is gonna win.
Hey, you're distracting me. I'm trying to count. It's hard for me to tell from the count because it's kind of distracting, but I think White's gonna win.
Mm.
Yeah, I have. All right, well, we'll take another break. We'll let the players get a little farther out in front, play some more endgame. Don't go anywhere. We'll stick it out to the end, you think? Maybe? Well, either way, we'll come back and we'll talk a little bit more about the endgame, so. We'll be back soon. Thanks very much. Hello, hello, everyone. We're back. We're back. We're joining you. We just are about to finish up the end game here. I'm Andrew Jackson. This is Jennie Shen, 2Pro, blessing us with her commentary this evening. Very grateful to have it. Thank you very much for sharing your insights on this game. Where would you say Black went wrong in this game? I totally just sandbagged you here because you said, let's go back and follow the game and finish the end game. And now you turn the cameras on and I just ask you a totally different question. Sorry. We can keep following along with the end game. I didn't mean to surprise you.
That's a good question. Where did Black go wrong?
Do we want to look at the opening again, maybe?
No.
No, okay. Just no.
Well, the whole time I was looking at, like, if white pushes and cut, and then this becomes a weakness, I would take white. But I didn't think about what did black go wrong, actually. I didn't think about it.
That must have been a chance, right? Mm-hmm. Could it have been plays this move, black jumps, or white jumps. He's left that cut behind.
I'm not sure. Sometimes you...
It's a new kid to play over here.
Sometimes you don't know what you did wrong and you just lost the game.
That's a frequent occurrence for me, actually. That I know that feeling very well.
I think still this area. Still this area. Maybe black should fix his cut.
Fix his
earlier.
Cut earlier?
Yes.
Okay.
Because after we saw this happen, right, and then white got this shoulder hit, I already feel like white is gonna... at least I would take white.
Right, right. I guess definitely the writing was on the wall once he had to give up these stones up here.
Yeah.
But that's definitely it there.
So what is the sequence right now? White played... Oh, okay.
The sequence right now, white plays up here.
White plays here.
So, yep. And then black Akari.
And this is a big move. Mm. I was looking at this one.
How big is it?
At this point, nothing is like 30 points.
Okay, so it's the biggest endgame.
Endgame. This is.
Sorry.
Black takes this one.
Mm-hmm.
White kills this actually.
This looks bigger than... No?
Don't ask me about endgame moves. Like,
okay.
How many points?
I don't know. I heard somebody asking me how many points. Mm-hmm. This is... You're telling me to count. I'm like, I don't know.
You know, it's like... I should not tell you not... I told you not to be lazy, but when I'm winning the game, I will be lazy. Because I know this way I will win. So I will not worry about this is bigger or that is bigger. Like, half a point bigger.
doesn't matter when the margin is this large.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. So
when it's a close game, then of course we pay attention to those. But when it's not as close... This is endgame technique or time?
It doesn't do anything. Yeah, that's a big one. Connect.
Yep. Hanging connection.
He's gonna finish this. Oh, he didn't block.
No, he
pushed
here.
He pushes here.
Probably close to the same. Capture. You got this one, and this one.
That's
kind of funny.
That's why endgame is boring. And this one?
Oh, yes.
Not yet. Oh, thank you.
And then block.
And there's nothing more.
Here. I think, you know, we can't actually see the feet of the players, so we don't know if they're counting, but it's possible that they've started.
Well, let's just finish it.
Let's just finish it. Okay, let's just finish it.
Make it easy.
We gotta do the right push. Here.
Oh, so we can just wait for the result.
I think
now
we can just
like
wait for the result.
This
now
is
it's
now
all
it's like 1 point, 1 point endgame moves.
Each of these moves is 1 point. All the same. Finally, the other center move that Shen has.
Yeah, this is 2 points.
Same, same. But it's always whites. Like, black is never going
to
get there.
That's why you need to turn.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I guess we'll just hang out and see what the result is.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for the game, Jennie. I really enjoyed that.
Yeah.
This is a sort of a textbook example of how to use the thickness that White had to keep the attack run, right? Once you've developed this thick position. Okay,
actually,
maybe I should let you tell me what textbook
I want to ask you, do you think these textbooks work for you?
No, I don't think there's any good textbooks. I think that's the problem.
No, I mean, like the textbook, the rules, like tells you how to use thickness, how to do this. Do you think all these things work for you?
I didn't do most of my learning from books. I didn't have a teacher until after I had already made one box. So it was very hard for me to say anything other than books.
So you just improve by reading books.
And doing problems, of course, and playing games. But I had to get the theory from books. But when I say it's a textbook example, I guess what I really mean is it's just a good example.
I know.
Yeah, so
like,
it's
well,
kind
we
of
want
lazy.
To do a lecture about how to use your thickness, how to attack, how to place up Aki.
Do they help?
I'm asking you.
Do they help? Do the lectures help? That's a really good question. I think that they help if the players are ready to hear it, right? It's kind of a silly way to answer that question, but I think that the right lecture at the right time, if the student can catch it and hold on to it and remember it, then yeah, it's amazing. But that epiphany, they have to be ready for that epiphany. The players are counting now, we're hearing. Thank you very much. It sounds like the players are counting. We'll have a result soon.
Yeah, we have. Okay.
Mm-hmm. What do you think? Do you think that they work? I mean, you've been teaching for a lot longer than I've been.
I'm teaching, but I don't know, like, the students, right? That's the question.
Oh, okay.
Do
for the student.
Work?
Does it do these things really, like, are they very helpful for you?
I tell you what, if we knew what actually worked, we could become very rich. If you knew what actually could help people learn to play Go better, I think, you know, there's a lot of folks who want to get better. And it's hard to find something that works for everyone.
I think it's different people, right?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, some people feel these things help a lot. Some people think it's not very helpful. Right, so it's different.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think that I used to do a lot of lectures, and it's like every position is different. So you tell people, okay, this is how you use thickness, and next time they do it wrong, it's
and they
like,
say you told me this in your lecture. And you're like,
yes,
it's different. It's a different situation, right?
Mm-hmm. So sometimes maybe they got this thing, like their situation is different, but they are doing. They are trying to recall what the lecture says. Okay, this is what the lecture says. Maybe I can do this, but that's a different situation. That's how they got it wrong. That happens a lot.
Right.
That's why. So like you learn this, and then next time something similar, but you didn't get it right, and then you still do it wrong. That's why I ask you if these things work for you.
I wish I had a better answer for you, but I feel like, you know, certainly this week is where we all have to try all the things that work for us.
Yeah.
So hopefully some of the broadcasts will work, maybe some of the lectures will work, some of the other options that we'll see this week will work. It seems like we've got a result. Black resigned, so White has won, Andy Liu has won.
Okay.
And that ends day one of our broadcast. So thank you so much, Jennie, for being with us. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome.
And I enjoyed it. I
hope we can find it. Thanks also to the broadcast team, Stephen, who has done a fabulous job making all the wonderful graphics that you've seen, driving the controls today, also being subject to Ming Ju's commentary this morning. He's also been helping with set up the Redmond Cup. Jennie, thank you for the Redmond Cup. The whole team of the e-journal has been delivering updates. You can track that at usgo.org. Let's see, am I missing anything?
I think my video session is finished.
Your video session, are you relieved?
Tomorrow I will start a review games.
You know, your video sessions are finished. My video sessions are finished. Yeah, it's pretty great. All right, so thanks everyone. We'll be back tomorrow morning starting at 9 o'clock. You can see the players. The commentary will probably start around 10 o'clock. And we'll see you then. Thanks, everyone. Good night.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.